Hello and welcome to the transcription explanation of this design. It was done using Loren Sherman's script, which uses a combination of dots, so like these modifiers, and lines, so like sometimes they're straight, sometimes they curve, and then these four different shaped letter stems. So there's the deep divot stem, which curves back in on itself, like here and here and these two. And then there's a circle inside the word circle, so like these, this one. And then there's a shallow divot stem, like this is the only one in the design here, where it's just a shallow arc. And then there's circles on the line of the word circle. So this is the word circle line, and this word actually has two of them, one here and one here. So vowels are smaller. There are these little circles, and they have different positions depending upon what vowel they are. So O's are always on the inside of the word circle, because this gray line is the word circle line. And A's are always on the outside of the word circle. So here's an A all by itself. There's another A there. And then E's are on the line of the word circle or inside the consonant stem. So here's the little vowels in this design. So let's go ahead and read it. You read from the bottom and then going counterclockwise, which is why this arrow is here like this, because you start at the bottom and then go counterclockwise around in a circle. And eventually spiral inwards, or just follow the path of the design. And that's true for both the sentence circles and then for words. So this sentence, I have starting at the bottom and then kind of going counterclockwise, hence the little curve thing here. But if you have something straight up and straight down, just follow the flow of the words. You either start at the bottom or start at the top. This one I started at the bottom to be a bit more traditional to what you read the script in. So you read the words bottom counterclockwise as well. So this is our very first letter of our very first word. And it's got a consonant vowel team, because there's the little vowel here, on a consonant stem. So you read the consonant and then the vowel. Always consonant first if they're together. So this consonant is a deep divot. And there's one line ending on it. So that's a G. So here's that one line there. So G. And then we have an O, because it's like a bead on a string. So they're color-coded. This brown one is the O's hanging out on our consonant stems. So there's the O, and then here's a second O. It's inside the word circle all by itself. So G-O-O, and then we have 1, 2, 3 dot modifiers, and it's a deep divot again, so that's a D. So this is the word good, and then we have this word. We have T-H. There are no lines ending on this, and line modifiers, they only count when they end on a letter stem, and they don't need to be straight. So this is a line modifier, but it doesn't end on this stem, so it doesn't count. So this is just a TH. And then we have an I. And I's are positioned like E's, so on the line of the word circle, except I has a line going inwards. So this blue line heading inwards is the I. I line. And if it were a U, it would have a line going outwards, and if it has no lines, it's an E. So this is an I, because it's got that inwards facing line. And then we have this NG. It's on the line of the word circle. So, like this, just like the TH, except it has 1, 2, 3 lines ending on it. These two thick ones and then that thin one. So that makes it an NG. And then we have an S with 1, 2, 3 lines on it as well. So that's the word things. And now we have this word, bottom of it's here. And we finally hit our first letter stem up here. And it's another D, 1, 2, 3 dots on a deep divot, just like this deep divot. And then there's the O on it. So this is an example of that the O always being after the stem it's attached to. So this is a G-O, this is a D-O. So even though the O is kind of lower than the D, you always read it second because it's attached. So this is the word do. And now we have this word. Here's the bottom of the word circle with our first stem. 1, 2 lines are modifying it, so that would be an H. And then we have the A. Again, lines that pass through don't count, so this one doesn't count. And then we have the A. And then we have a double line. And a double line means it's a double letter. And because the lines are the same thickness, it's the same letter twice. So this is the only section in the whole design where thickness matters. Otherwise, it was just my artistic choice to make some lines thicker and thinner. These two little rings right here have to be the same thickness. Otherwise, it shows that it's two different letters. But because they're the same thickness, it's the same letter twice. So the same letter twice, and they have 1, 2 line modifiers, so that would be a double P, so H-A-P-P, and then E, and then one line on the N, so happen. And then we have a comma, so So I don't have the punctuation stuff on this, but a single filled in dot on a sentence circle is a comma, and a sentence circle goes around word circles. So I have it going around just the one word circle here. Typically be around the whole sentence, but you can just put it in between two words if you have a relatively linear design like this. So this is the comma. And then we have Dean. D with three dots, just like this D, just like this D. An E on the line of the word circle, just like that E. An A, just like that A. And then an N, just like this N, with a line on it. So Dean. So good things do happen, Dean. So there are some supernatural circles for you. I hope you like the design. I'm looking forward to sharing it on my gallery. And I hope it makes a wonderful cat tattoo for you. I hope you like it. Bye.